Today we're going to talk about 4.2, solving systems of linear equations by substitution. Same rules apply as they applied in 4.1. There are three solution types. You have the most common where you get an actual point, and be careful, it is an x, y point. So make sure you type in the whole point as your solution. You can always check those by plugging them back in. And you have your two special cases where, again, one is false. It has no solutions, which is here. If both variables disappear, and it's a false statement, your answer is no solution. If, when you solve it, both variables cancel out, and it's a true statement, then we have infinite solutions. And that's where we write it as the actual ordered pair, comma, and list an actual equation. Both of those are my special cases. Both of them, the variables disappear or eliminate, cancel, and you ask yourself what type of case you have. When you're using substitution, you want to use it only, honestly, when you can easily solve for one variable. And what I mean by that is you want x equals or y equals. And you really don't want to have to deal with fractions if you can help it. So sometimes you have to, but if you have a choice, that would be the only time I could do it. So you're going to take one of the equations, solve it for a variable, substitute it into the other equation so that you have one variable left to solve. Remember, though, that you're finishing these by getting an ordered pair as a solution. So on this first equation, we're going to take the equation that is already solved for y. And I generally always put the equation that I have solved in a box because I'm going to use it at the beginning and I'm going to use it at the end. And remember, we're plugging it into the first equation. So I'm plugging it in for y. So I'm going to type 7x minus 2 equals negative 2, and I am substituting in the 3x for y. So now I have an equation with one variable. So I'm going to simplify that. So 7x minus 6x gives me an x equals a negative 2. Why I like to box it when I've solved with substitution is I'm going to come back and plug it back in to get the answer for my y coordinate. My y coordinate is y equals 3x. So that means it's 3 times negative 2, which is negative 6. Super important, your answer is the ordered pair, negative 2, negative 6. Make sure you put the x first and the y second. Easy way to check it, make sure it works for both equations. Now, number 1 already had y equals. Number 2 does not. So it's actually your choice on if you want to take this second equation and multiply it by negative 1. Or, in this case, I actually am going to take it and move the 2 over and use x equals negative y plus 2. So now I'm going to take this and plug it back into the original equation for x. So I'm going to plug in the negative y plus 2, which is here for x. So I'm going to distribute. Gives me a negative 5y plus 10 minus 3y. I have one variable, so I can solve this. This gives me a negative 8y plus 10 equals negative 6. Subtract 10 from both sides, which gives me a negative 16. Divide both sides by a negative 8. Be careful. This gives me a positive 2. I'm going to now take this and go back to that original piece and substitute it in. So I'm going to type in here now, x equals a negative 2 plus 2, which gives me 0. That negative here was that piece there. So be careful here. We solved this. We got x equals 0 and y equals 2. That is my solution. Make sure you list it as x first, y second. Easy to check. Plug it back into each equation and make sure it makes a true statement. So going to number 3 here, this one's not as easy to do because there's not necessarily one that's directly, you can see that I would actually substitute in. But if I looked at this one, I would take the top equation because I don't want any fractions. I would subtract 2y from both sides. And then I would divide each term by a negative 1 to get rid of that. So I'd get x equals a positive 2y minus 8. I'm now going to plug that into the second equation. So 4 times parentheses. So I have 2y minus 8 that I plug in. This gives me 8y minus 32 minus 8y equals 1. Be careful. The 8y and the minus 8y cancel and cross them out so that you make sure you don't put a y there. Because a y means there's a 1y left. I end up with negative 32 equals 1. Whenever my variables disappear, I ask myself if it's a true or false statement. This is false, which means they never intersect. My answer is empty set. Truly what it means is that these two lines are parallel, picture-wise. Makes you understand what happens when you get your special cases because you will have them on the test. I get a lot of people, when they get to these problems on the test, they forget to solve for both x and y. Make sure you remember it is actually an ordered pair. There are extra examples in Canvas using this method as well.